An expression that contains variables can only be evaluated if the values of the variables are known. The process of evaluating the expression once the values are known is called substitution. You can substitute a value into an expression by replacing the variable with its value, being careful to follow the normal convention for order of operations. Let me show you what I mean. Evaluate 2a minus 3 if a equals 7. We have a value for the variable a, so we can substitute it into the expression 2a minus 3. But be careful. Don't just replace the a with a 7 as a purely written replacement. You've forgotten about the implied multiplication. This is not a 2 followed by an a, which ends up as 27. It's 2 times a. When you substitute a numeric value, be careful to write out the implied operation, or use brackets if you need to. 2a becomes 2 times 7. I have substituted a equals 7 into the expression. Now I can evaluate using the normal order of operations. Times first, 2 times 7 is 14. Then subtract. 14 minus 3 is 11. Notice my setting out here. I'm working vertically down the page. All the equal signs are lined up, and when I replace things with calculated values, I write the new value directly underneath what it replaces. This is important. It helps to explain what I'm doing. At each step, it is clear what I've changed. And it also helps with finding any mistakes. Let's try a few more. Evaluate 4 plus 3p if p equals 8. So, where the p is, put 8. But again, it's not 3, 8, which would be 38. It's 3 times 8. Now follow the normal order of operations. 3 times 8 is 24, and 4 plus 24 is 28. Evaluate 2 brackets v plus 1 if v equals 9. So, substitute the value of 9 where the v is. Now evaluate. Brackets first. 9 plus 1 equals 10, and there's an implied multiplication between the 2 and the brackets. 2 times 10 is 20. Now, exactly the same process works if you have multiple variables, or if the same variable appears more than once. Evaluate r squared minus 3 times r plus s if r equals 3 and s equals negative 1. So what we're going to do is put a 3 wherever there's an r, and a negative 1 wherever there's an s. Sometimes you may need brackets to substitute a negative number, but in this case we're okay. So now we have 3 squared minus 3 times brackets 3 plus negative 1, close bracket. Okay, exponents first. 3 squared is 9. And we can actually do the brackets at the same time. 3 plus negative 1 is 2. It's the same as 3 minus 1. 9 minus 3 times 2. Do the times. 3 times 2 is 6. Then 9 minus 6 is 3. Notice how the vertical setting out works here, down the page. Even though I did two things at once for one of those steps, it's still clear what I did, because things that are the same are vertically lined up, one under the other. It's very easy to follow. Let's try one more. Evaluate 2x plus 5 all over y if x equals 5 and y equals 3. It's a fraction, but that's okay. Just do exactly the same thing as before. Substitute the values we have for the variables. X becomes 5 and y becomes 3. Notice how important it is here that your letter X doesn't look anything like a time sign. That X on the first line needs to be very different from the multiply sign on the second. This is also why some people prefer to use a single dot for multiplication instead of the cross, just to make it that much more different. I'd advise caution here against that. You don't want this to look like 2.5. Now evaluate. The fraction line for division actually implies a kind of brackets around everything on top of it, so we'll be doing the fraction division last. On the top, the multiplication will be first, followed by the addition. 2 times 5 is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15. Then finally, I have 15 over 3, which is 15 divided by 3, which equals 5. Notice something else, too. Notice how important it is to write this fraction vertically, with the numerator actually above the denominator and a horizontal vinculum. Take plenty of space for these fractions. If you tried to write each one horizontally or with a diagonal slash, written small and squashed up on one line, it would get pretty messy and it wouldn't be nearly so clear what was happening at each step. Take the extra space and write it neatly and vertically. Get into this habit. It really does make doing algebra much easier.